everybody, and welcome to The Balancing Act. I'm Julie Moran.
And I'm Olga Villaverde. Today we've got amazing story of survival and facing heartache head on, Laura Saltman. She's here with us to share her personal journey from TV personality to motivational speaker and author.
Plus, we'll be learning more about something that will affect us all, and that is finding the right retirement facility.
A packed show, a very special show. Stay tuned. It all starts
right now.
She's an Emmy-nominated journalist, motivational speaker, and author with a background in entertainment and lifestyle programming. Laura Saltman combines journalism with the spiritual, adding in heart, humor, and a little bit of pop culture to motivate people to be their best, most authentic self. Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Thanks for being here. I love that, to be their best.
Absolutely.
Let's talk about your past. You've had quite a career, haven't you?
Yeah. You know what? I'm so grateful to have been on Access Hollywood.
Oh, Access Hollywood.
Yep. I was their digital correspondent. I did their weekend show. And, you know, I've covered everything.
Red
I've covered
carpet.
The Oscars, the Emmys, the Golden Globes. I was the American Idol's biggest cheerleader when that show was on.
Kardashians.
And so, yeah, the Kardashians, you name it, J-Lo. I was obsessed with J-Lo. And, you know, I was living quite an amazing life. And
so
then
what
everything
happened?
Changed. Well, first of all, you know, it's a rewarding life, but it's also takes its toll. It's
it does.
A lot of superficial
it's very
things.
It's superficial. Mm-hmm. It's somewhat difficult sometimes.
Yes.
You've got to put a different face on.
Yeah.
Right?
And towards the end of my run at Access Hollywood, my brother actually was diagnosed with cancer, and he died of stomach cancer about a year after he was diagnosed.
I'm so sorry.
And so that changes your life. It
of course
puts
it does.
Everything in perspective.
How
for
old
you.
Is he?
He was 47. And that's where everything in my life changed. And then about a year and a half later, my dad committed suicide. I say that he lost his will to live. And he had some other problems. He had COPD and some other things. But I think he really just didn't want to live after he lost his firstborn son.
So and you lose your brother and father.
Yes, within a span of a year and a half. And that's not it. I mean, I had two miscarriages. My now ex-husband and I were trying to adopt, and we lost three babies through different reasons in adoption. The last one on the day the baby was born. And then I got divorced. I was diagnosed with skin cancer. I mean, things just kept piling up in my life.
And how did you get through that, if I could ask?
Yeah, I found a spiritual path. I had met with this spiritual life coach who helped me, and I worked with her for 2 years. And in that, she kind of opened up this intuitive gift I kind of always knew I had. I mean, in my book, you can read all
like
the stories
calling,
of like where, yeah, like where I would hear things and like weird things would happen. I would like walk into a room and be like, oh, there's ghosts in here. I can feel it. I know it. Those type of things. So she helped me open that up. And she also opened my eyes to a better way of life to connect with, you know, whatever you call that. It's God, spirit, source, universe, whatever you want to call it.
Which led to then
and
your
which
book.
Is this led to my book in the
Meet
middle
all
of the night.
Of everything.
A spiritual guide to inner world domination.
You asked questions on the red carpet, and here you're asking questions to God. You're
yeah.
having a conversation with God.
Yes, it is. It's very similar to a conversation with God, which is a Neil Donald
that.
Walsh book. It's like a Q&A. I sat down in the middle of the night and I just started asking questions, and sure enough, the answers would come right back to me.
And how has that helped you?
The book is life-changing. When you read it, it's explaining things in a way that it's so simple to understand, and it's really so easy to know that we're all connected to that source and we all can tap into it, whether you call it prayer or intention mm-hmm. or whatever it is for you, controlled emotion, whatever it is, knowing that we are guided by this source and we can tap back into that at any time we're struggling. And that's really what has been taught to me. And I use those principles myself. And when I am having hard times, I stop for a second, I pray, I meditate, I set my intentions, I do everything that's in this book.
And you obviously
want
to help others as well.
And I want to help other people. You know, Olga, we all are not going to get out of this life unscathed.
No.
We all have our problems.
We
My problems are hard, but there's plenty of people who have even worse problems. So I want people to know that there is a better way. You can go through tragedy, you can go through loss, and you can come out the other side by using this knowing, this connection to get yourself out of that. And
I
live
love
a
how
better
you
life.
End here, and I wanted to read this real quick. It says, I am living proof that if you do the work, set intentions, pray daily, ask questions, and recognize the signs and messages, life can be joyful and miraculous even after heartache and tragedy.
Your signs and messages are everywhere if you just look for them.
For our viewers to learn more about you and this fabulous book, where do they go, Laura?
Just go to my website, laurasaltman.com.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks so much for being here.
Thank you.
God bless you. And you can always go to our website to learn more about the all of everything about Laura. Go to thebalancingact.com. over 70 million baby boomers, the face of retirement is really changing. Today, there are better ways to age successfully and stay independent longer. Here to help us redefine what independence means in 2018 are Lily Donahue and Rick Wigington from Holiday Retirement. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you so much for having us.
Thanks for being here. Let's talk about, you know, the fact that people are living longer, they're healthier, life expectancy is amazing, right? But when you get to that age where the children are worried about you, you know what happens, right? You don't want to give up that independence. And for the children, it's challenging.
It is.
Isn't it?
It really is. You know, we always think that it's just getting challenging for the older person.
Mm-mm.
But in reality, the family member that's trying so hard to keep them in their apartment as long as possible, even though it might not be the best solution. So everyone's kind of in a stressed manner.
People think independence is owning my own house.
Yeah.
You're going to take
me
boots first.
Yes.
I'm not leaving this house.
It's mine. I'm staying here.
All the while it's getting littler and littler because they've built this mausoleum to themselves, all the preciouses and pretties in this house that they can't let go of. And there's a big world out there they could still be living in.
And now you're bringing, you know, a memory for me of my grandmother who passed away years ago, but she lived to be 96.
Yeah.
And when I say 96, you know, 20/20 vision, she still walked around the block,
wow.
Did exercise. We called her Abby. So we loved Abby very much. And I remember my mom wanting to kind of telling her, you need to move out of the house. She was like, no. Me quedo aquí. I'm going to stay here. So how do you help someone like that? Maybe some tips on letting go?
Yeah. The first most important thing is to let go. And sometimes it's really the adult caregiver. Many cases in the U.S., it's always the daughter. I had to make those same decisions for my parents. You got to let go. You can't solve the world's problems. You're already doing a big balancing act, right? You're trying to manage your career, you're trying to manage your own family, and then you're trying to manage your elderly parents, and in some cases, your elderly parents of your spouse. So there's a lot going on. I think you got to let go a little bit, because there's really some great help out there. And more importantly, that alternative option could actually be a better one for them to live more active and be engaged.
Other tips, Rick?
And moving is hard. It's always been hard. But it's also been a normal part of what we do. Anytime we recognize that you could live better near term, whether it's for our own family, you want your kids in a different school district, you're making a little more money, you want a nicer house, the kids move off, you want to downsize. We've always moved. But we do so when we think that life could be better. If we move to a different place.
Mm-hmm.
I would say research. So as we were talking about this, you got to do your research. You want to sit with your family members and decide, what are you really looking for? What problems are actually getting harder at home for you? Be honest about them and then say, okay, these are the things we want to solve. Because not every community solves the same issues for you. So it's important to do that. It's important to think about location, right, as part of that. So what are the needs or what are the things that are getting harder at home? And then location, is it important? Do I need to be close to my children? Or do I need to be close to my community of where
sure.
I used to
all
live?
All those factors are really
all those
important.
Things.
And knowing that it's a positive step, right?
Yeah, exactly.
And that's important.
And I'd say the final advice or tip is don't get discouraged in the process.
But this is the problem with the discouragement. You say, you know, you sit the mom down or the dad, whoever it is, and you say, you know, it's a retirement community. And what happens? Deer in the headlights.
Absolutely.
Negative connotation, right?
Absolutely.
So how do we change that? Because that's not easy to hear.
Well, it's that old stereotype of nursing home light or sickly, frail. It's the place you go to end.
Everybody's like this, not moving, no one's going to take care of me.
It is so different now with modern senior living communities.
And let's talk about that. I know you're located in 42 states, correct?
Mm-hmm.
All right, which is a lot, practically all over the country.
Exactly.
And you're very unique in your approach, so tell me about that. Let's now bring this now into a positive step.
Absolutely. There's so many cool things to do in our communities. Obviously, the meal preparation is a big, important piece.
Yeah.
Because as we know, we get older, what you put in your body still really matters, and oftentimes older people will choose what's easy to do. So now that problem is kind of taken away for you, right? So you can eat better. You're obviously being more active because you've got a bunch of friends and you've got some activities that the whole community is kind of putting together. Mm-hmm. So whether it's dancing or singing or going to a museum, there's lots of things to do. Yeah, really cool stuff. And one of the coolest things about Holiday, I think, is from my parents, I think this is one of the neatest ideas, is because we're in 42 states and we have over 260 communities, you can actually, it's part of your all-inclusive, so it's no additional cost to you, you can actually travel to any Holiday community, stay for a week, hang out with
I want to go be with my BFF.
Exactly.
She's in Boca while I'm in Fort Lauderdale.
Then you do it. You do it, you set up, you schedule
it. Or you meet
you
somebody special, and I want to go see him.
I wasn't going to say that, but I was definitely thinking it. We've had marriages and relationships develop, okay?
I love it.
Yeah. So the idea is
really, but it's
like,
real.
It's real, and it's real life, right? That's what's cool. What you're trying to do is you're trying to keep real life going.
Yeah.
It's real people
That's
serving
fantastic.
Real people, and so it's a really neat thing.
What about affordability, Rick?
We're very modestly priced. You know, there are some options you could spend north of $20,000 a month. And then there's government low-income subsidized options for elderly people.
Okay.
We're right in the middle. And with over 30,000 folks who currently call us home, a lot of people think we're the best value for the dollar.
Well, I think I found my place for my husband and
Yay!
Me when we grow old together.
We'll be there with you.
For our viewers who would like more information right now, where would they go?
Oh, so you can absolutely go on our website, which is holidaytouch.com. But more importantly, I'm sure you'll agree with me, is go visit one of our communities.
Yeah.
We're in 42 states. We're probably, you know, very close to where you are. You'll never learn better about what's happening in our communities than meeting the people that are working mm-hmm. there and meeting the people who live there.
Fantastic. Mm-hmm. I would definitely need salsa and merengue every day.
Hey, okay. We can take care of that
Very
for you.
Very important. I'll see you soon. And of course, if you'd like more information, you can go to our website, and that's thebalancingact.com.
Hi, I'm Carrie Greenberg. I'm a children's stylist, I'm a proud wife, and I'm a mother of a two-year-old boy. As a fashion and beauty blogger, I'm always looking for the latest trends and beauty products just for you guys. So I'm super excited to try out this new skincare line by Foreo.
Hi guys, Carrie here, coming to you from the bathroom. I'm really excited to try out these Luna 2 products.
Foreo came out with a bunch of different products, which is awesome depending on what you're looking for in your skin routine. First up, we have the Luna 2, and I really like this product because it's soft, it's really easy to hold, it's lightweight, the bristles are really nice on your face. It also has an anti-aging effect on the back, which is great for any fine lines or wrinkles that you may have. So it also comes in four different models, which is perfect for any skin type that you may have. I have normal skin, so this was the version that I picked out to try. It also has a vibration effect, and you can change the speed on the bottom here. And they say you're gonna get younger looking skin and a luminous effect, and who doesn't want that? Here's how it works. You're gonna take your facial cleanser and you're gonna apply it to your brush. You're gonna add a little bit of water. And then you're gonna activate your device. You're gonna start washing your face like you normally would to get rid of all the dirt and makeup that you've accumulated all day long. So once your face is dry, you activate your device again, and then you can start working on those fine lines and wrinkles, which is great for a busy mom like me who doesn't have a lot of time to take care of their skin. The next one I want to tell you guys about is the Luna Mini 2, and this is perfect for a younger generation. 1 hour of charging lasts 7 months. You're going to have this for a long time, and you never have to replace the brush. It has 8 adjustable speed settings, and it's great for all different skin types. The Luna Mini 2 comes in 5 different colors, so you can choose any color that you like. Another great product that they came out with is the Luna Play, and not only is it cute and small and perfect to travel with, but it's nice when you don't know which product out of the line that you want to invest in. So this is a really great product to choose. And the last one is the Luna 2 for men, which is obviously perfect for my husband because he's always stealing my Luna 2. So now he has his very own.
After only a few days of using my Luna 2, my skin feels amazing. The bristles on the one side are really soft, so it never feels like too much pressure or that it's too harsh. It's never uncomfortable. It just feels like it's working. My skin feels so incredibly soft, and you can tell that all the dirt and makeup that has built up throughout the day is immediately removed. You can go to bed knowing that this product did an amazing job. It's something that you can rely on and know that you'll have to worry about that. That's one thing you can check off your list.
Olives and olive oils give any meal a flavorful and heart-healthy boost. And today we're using products from the experts in Mediterranean food, Star. And it's so great to have you here,
Thank you.
Stuart.
That's right, Julie. Olives are full of flavor and low in calories. And add them to any meal or just eat them straight out of the jar like I like to do.
I like to eat them straight out of the jar, but also I see martini glasses and I love a
yes.
martini. How about a dirty
martini? The perfect drink. I'm just going to add in
And these are queen olives, right?
These are queen olives. They're perfect.
Perfect, yeah.
For martinis. I'm really like shaking or stirring. I mean, it's too late.
Oh,
I shook
James
it already.
Bond here.
All right. Pierce Brosnan. Right?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to do this. We'll pop that in there.
There we go.
Nice color in that.
That is.
Love that.
That looks fantastic. Let me taste it.
For you, madam.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Now, cocktail, you need a good little appetizer with it.
That's so good.
That's so tasty.
Yum.
Right, so we got same olives again, the queen. These are an essential for any, like, charcuterie, like, you know,
these have to be in my fridge.
Yes, all the time. Pantry staple or fridge staple. These are covered in cream cheese and gouda.
Oh, my God.
And rolled in walnuts. Perfect
appetizer. You've got a little crunch.
Because you know what? You don't want your guests to be cranky. Get them eating as soon as they walk in that door.
These are fantastic.
Straight over.
This looks so good.
This is even great too. You can make this and cut it up, put it beside those.
Yum.
They could snack in that as well when they come in. So we have some olives, we have some mozzarella cheese, some butter and garlic on here. They could really just elevate a garlic toast.
And what's your favorite way to incorporate olives and olive oil into your everyday recipes?
If I want to like elevate it or just add like a bit more like saltiness in there without the crazy amount of sodium.
Yes, just add.
I just chop them up and just add them in there.
Perfect
I love
idea.
Like a chicken like sauce, like a cacciatore. It's really, really nice.
Oh,
one of my
yeah.
favorites to make.
Perfect.
Yeah. So we're gonna make a pesto. So I got some basil here, super easy recipe, and we're gonna use some olives. And I don't have to add Parmesan cheese in here because I get the saltiness already from the olives.
Low sodium, but not low on flavor.
Exactly.
I love that.
We can leave the Parmesan cheese to garnish at the very end.
Okay.
And we got some sun-dried tomatoes, super beautiful, and of course some garlic. Pulse that for a second, and we're gonna stream in our extra virgin olive oil. Just like, you know.
I noticed you had 6 ingredients. I wonder why.
I wonder why either. I mean, maybe because I wrote a book. I don't know. Just gonna add that olive oil in. And this is super great too because I have some pasta here beside me, right? So I have some tagliatelle pasta. We're gonna add this pesto into it, okay?
That looks so good.
But if you've any left over, put on some bruschetta, cut it up, put on some bruschetta when people come over. This is so good, or even on toast in the morning with some scrambled eggs.
Yum.
Super delicious. Okay, I'm just gonna add that in there.
I love it, I've had an appetizer, I've had my drink, I'm gonna have my entree, all good.
All with olives and the olive oil. So I'm just gonna mix that around, toss it.
And olive oil and olives, so good for your heart.
So good, I love a pesto.
I love a pesto.
And of course, if you wanted to add shrimp to this, you could too, or my favorite go-to, rotisserie chicken, shred it up.
Oh,
yeah. That's really good. Do you want to taste that?
This.
Finish it up with some Parmesan cheese.
Another sip of the martini.
Just like that, just a tiny bit. You don't need much.
I'm in heaven. I'm in such heaven right now.
You basically got a full meal in a few minutes.
In a few minutes. All right, you want to find more ways to be good to your heart? Check out the most highly recommended products from the ultimate trusted authority in Mediterranean food, starfinefoods.com, or of course, our website, thebalancingact.com.
And please don't forget to share your favorite recipes with us. And if you want more great recipes, do check out my cookbook, The Quick 6 Fix.
His book is fantastic, and I want more of this pasta. That's what I want. Make this. You'll love it. And we want you to check us out, our website, Twitter, Facebook. We are everywhere.
Thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you next time.
So long.